Reverend Dr. Christine Isigi, welcome you. This is Prophetess Reverend Dr. Christine Isigi, welcome you. I welcome you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Good morning, everyone. This is Overcomers, Deliverance and Healing Ministry. Our ministry is based on spiritual warfare. That's why I'm coming to you to help you to understand that we are on the battle. We are on the war, and God has given us power and authority. The word of God itself is as power and authority. In the name of Jesus, welcome once again. In Jesus' name, amen. Today I'm going to talk to you the truth that the words do have power and authority. The truth is that the word of God has power and authority. Therefore, I'm going to read from the book of Matthew 8, 7 to 11. But I'm going to speak only one word there, few words, not everything. Because I have so much to go, I have to go with you slowly, and you see how the power, how the word of God has power and authority. Yes, thank you very much. Welcome. Hallelujah. Let's look at Matthew 8, verse 7 to 11. Matthew 8, verse 7 to 11. And also we can look in the book of Luke 7, 7. Let's look first Matthew. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Let's look in the Matthew. Thank you, Jesus. Matthew 8. The book of Matthew 8, verse 7 to 11. The Bible says, "And Jesus said unto him, I will come and heal him. The centurion answered and said, Lord, I am not worthy that thou should come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my servant shall be healed." Speak the word. The word has authority. The word has power. The centurion told Jesus, "Don't come to my roof. You don't need to come. Like as I'm talking to you now, I don't need to come to you. I will speak the word. God has given me power to speak the word in you. You need a word. You need a man of God to speak the word in you. You need a prophet to speak the word in you. You need a man or a woman of God to speak the word over your life. This is what you are looking for. Now the centurion said, you don't need to come to my roof. You don't need to come to me. Just speak the word. The Bible says, he sent the word and the word healed them. He sent the word that we speak is power. It has fire. It is a living word. When we release the word to the person, to the life, that is what it will happen. The centurion told Jesus, you don't need to come to my home. You don't need to waste your time. Just speak the word because I believe you. Once you believe the word of God, it will be well with you. It will be done everything you want. That's why God has given me power and authority to speak the word over you. No matter what the devil is saying. Yesterday, a witch called me, and in the spirit I saw she's a witch, and this woman, she pretended that she wanted me to pray for her, and I know she's a witch, and I was ready for her. Now when she pretended that she wanted me to pray for her, she wanted to affect my voice. She wanted to attack me, my voice, to attack my voice. So when she was speaking, she was chanting, she was calling my voice. And now I said, in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. That person fell and she never talked to me. The phone was on. I called, hello, hello. The phone was on, but the person went off. Up to today, I don't know if that woman died or what happened to her. God knows. I'm telling you, we have word. People call me, different people, even mental people, sick people, mad people, they call me sometimes. They ask me some question and some stuff. When I speak the word goes like thunder. When I speak the word of God is fire itself. That's what the Bible says. The Bible says the word of God has authority and power. Now the Saint George said, you don't need any, you don't need to come to me. Just speak the word. I am going to speak the word over your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Your enemy, that is against you, shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, you call me and I will speak the word against your enemy. Because the Bible has given us power and authority over your word. Look at the Bible. This is the Bible which says here. If you look at Luke 7 verse 7, the Bible says, hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. Jesus is good. Luke 7, verse 7. Luke 7, verse 7. Glory be the name of Jesus. God is awesome God. The Bible says, wherefore neither, thought I myself worthy to come unto thee, but say in a word, and my servant shall be healed. For I also am a man set under authority, having under me a soldiers, and I say unto one, go, and he goeth, and to another, come, and he cometh. To my servant, do this, and he do it. So, the man told Jesus that I am also a man of authority. When I command my soldiers to do what I said, they do it. So, therefore, you don't need to come to my house. You don't need to come to my roof. You speak the word. Because the word has power. The word has authority. The word of God has authority. I want to share with you the word of God from the book of Jeremiah 1. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. The book of Jeremiah 1 verse 7. Thank you, Jesus. The book of Jeremiah 1 verse 9. The book of Jeremiah 1 verse 9. Then the Lord put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord said unto me, behold, I have put my words in the mouth. See, I have this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdoms to root out, to pull down, and to destroy, and to throw down, to build, and to plant. You see, God put a word in the mouth of Jeremiah. God has put a word in my mouth. And he has said to build and destroy, to uproot and to plant. Therefore, I am coming to destroy. I am coming to cast out the enemy that is working against you. I am breaking every curse that has been issued against you. Because the Bible says, I will destroy and build and plant in the name of Jesus. I am coming to you because the word of God is alive. The word itself is alive. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. My Father, I thank you. This is the word of God. It could never change. The word of God would never change. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God, I thank you. Yes, Lord. I will speak to the mountain, a problem, and direct it to removed. And it will be removed. I will speak to you the word of the living God. What mountain are you facing? What mountain are you facing to this morning? What problem are you facing? Because God has given me power and authority. He has put a word in my mouth to cast out and to plant and to destroy and to dismantle. When we cast anything, the Bible says, when we bind anything on earth, it will be bound in heaven. When we loose anything in the earth, it will be loose in heaven. Where two or three are gathered in the midst is there. Therefore, the power that God has given us, this is not a joke. That's why you need to call me to break and cast out your enemies. We have been given power and authority. The witches from your father's house, the witches from your mother's house, that does not want you to go, you call me, I will deal with them in the name of Jesus Christ. You can't live such a life, and Jesus Christ has given us power and authority. Power that God has given us, he has given us. Look at the word of Jeremiah. He has said that, see, I have this day set thee over the nations and over the kingdom to root out and to pull down and to destroy and to throw down and to build and to plant. You've been given power and authority to destroy and to dismantle. Therefore, every word of the enemy shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. Luke 10 verse 19, Jesus himself said, I have given you power and authority. The word Jesus has given to us, it is power and authority. Therefore, when we use the word of God, the demon has to obey and go. When we cast the demon, get out of the person, it has to go. Our ministry is a ministry of human resources. Our ministry has turned to be emergency. I tell you, the woman was dying. The woman called me in Arizona from USA. This woman, she had a very severe pain on one of our side going through the chest. It was very sharp pain and it was very painful. She called me. She could not stand. She could not bend. She was like powerless. The arrow was sent to her to kill her. A witch sent the arrow to her to kill her. The woman is a teacher. And this woman, she didn't know what to do, but she remembered to call me immediately. She's one of who follows me, and she always supports me, God. This woman, she can support. If I need anything, this woman will give me. If I say I don't have anything, she will give me. The woman is supporting this ministry, and she lives in States. Now, when she called me, I speak the word to her, and then the pain slowed and the pain went away. This woman, she was going to die. She was sent an arrow of death. That is called heart attack. That's how people die. I'm telling you that the word that God has given me, it is a powerful word. Sometimes I look at myself, I say I'm not an ordinary person. Because God has given me powerful word. And I want to put this the word on you. You need the word of God. Look at this centurion man. The centurion told Jesus, I need a word. I only need a word. You don't have to come to me. You need a word. Gladys, you need the word of God. Chike, you need the word of God. My son, you need the word to be spoken over your life. That's why the prophets are there for you, to prophesy and speak live word. If you have been cast, I will reverse that curse and break it and send it back to the sender. If witchcraft have put a curse on you, I will reverse it and destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. I break some curses. I break some witchcraft curses. If witchcraft are terrifying you, giving you problem in your work or anywhere you are, call me. I will destroy them. I will come for them. The witchcraft, they must die. They will be destroyed in Jesus' name. Father, in the name of Jesus, I command every child of the devil, every Lucifer, messenger of the devil, assigned to afflict anyone, assigned to chant against our prayers, assigned to attack anyone, I command the hand of God to turn on you. I command the power and the blood of Jesus to destroy you. I curse you in the name of Jesus. I see a demon reasoning and chanting and trying to attack this prayer and trying to attack people. I command fire of God to consume you. I take authority against you, demon. I curse you and I bind you. I destroy you by fire. I command the fire of God to consume you right now, wherever you are, in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, destroy them. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost fire, paralyze them. Holy Ghost fire, destroy them. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I come against the child of the devil that is attacking you every time, that does not want you to go. I destroy them by fire. Remember Jeremiah 9, what the Bible says. The Bible says here, Jeremiah 9 to 10, the Bible says, see, I have this day set over the nations and over the kingdoms to root out and to pull down, and to destroy, and to throw down, to build, and to plant. I destroy the works of the devil. I destroy every work of the enemy working against your life. I destroy them by fire, by thunder. Let the thunder of God thunder every problem you are facing. Any power that is following you, that does not want to get out of your life, let them be destroyed. Any power, you demon of addiction, I command the fire of God to consume you. Any sickness in your body, the pain in your mouth, the pain in your body, in your back, in your neck, I destroy them. The Bible says we will destroy them. I destroy every pain in your body. I destroy every storm that you are facing, every mountain that you are facing, every issues that you are facing, I destroy them. Financial problem, I curse you and I destroy you in Jesus' name. Every spells and chants, I destroy you in the name of Jesus Christ. Every incarnation, hences, voodoos, hopis, I destroy you in Jesus' name. The power that God has given us power to destroy, has given us power to come against the enemies. You look at that. See, I've set you over the kingdom of darkness. Every kingdom of darkness, I destroy you. Every powers of darkness working against you, I destroy you. Powers of eliminate, I destroy you. Powers of devil worshippers, flee mansion, powers of darkness, I come against you. I destroy you by fire, by thunder, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I will use my authority by speaking to any problem that is stopping God's work in your life in Jesus' name. Therefore, I take the authority by the power in the blood of Jesus to destroy everything that is working against you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Spirit husband, get out of this woman. You, that spirit husband, taking away the husband's woman, I condemn you and I cast you out in the name of Jesus. I bind you and I render you powerless in Jesus' name. You strange woman, taking away the husband of this woman, I am coming against you. I cast you in the name of Jesus. I bind you and I destroy you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Spirit wife, hear the word of God. Leave this man. Leave this man. Get away from this man in the mighty name of Jesus. Spirit wife, hear the word of God. I bind you. I destroy you in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty enemy that is holding you from getting married. Enemy that is holding you from getting a husband. Enemy that is holding you from to be married. I destroy that strong man. I destroy that strong woman. I destroy the powers of the kingdom in the mighty name of Jesus. My God and my Father, in the name of Jesus. Every power that is working against you at your workplace, enemies that is working with those agents of darkness, affecting you, disrespecting you, they don't recognize you. Hear the word of God. Enemies working against you at your workplace, the workplace that you are working, everyone is against you. I command those spirits, those demons that is working with Satan in your workplace to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Be destroyed. I bind them and I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. Your mother in laws, your in laws that is affecting you, that is fighting you, I command those demons that is working with them to be destroyed, because the word of God has given us power and authority. I take authority over against the demons that is working with your in laws, your mother in laws and in laws. Let those demons be destroyed and be bind and be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus. Every problem that you are facing, I take authority over them. The case in the court, I destroy them. The Bible says we have been given power and authority to go to the heaven and release you. You've been repent. You have repented. You have repented. You have asked God to forgive you. God has forgiven you. No power of darkness will hold you again in the mighty name of Jesus. No condemnation. There shall be no condemnation against those who believe in the word of God. Romans 8 says there shall be no condemnation to those who believe in the Lord. You might be accused falsely, but in the name of Jesus Christ, your accuser will go down and you will go up. Let those accusers be destroyed. I am cursing them because the word has said we shall destroy them. We have uprooted them from their roots. I destroy every evidence of satanic evidence. I destroy every false witness by the power in the blood of Jesus. Anyone who is having a case court, that is having a case court, I am taking authority against that case by the power in the blood of Jesus. Jesus has set you free. Jesus has set you free. Jesus has forgiven you. God himself has forgiven you. Therefore, I take the authority by the power in the blood of Jesus. Because the word of God has authority and power, I am using this word to destroy that God. When that God, that case is, I destroy them. I bind them. I loose them. I cast them in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty marriage cases that is in the court, let the enemy that has taken that case to court to be defeated and be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let the enemy be disgraced and rendered powerless by the authority and the power that we have been given. Jesus has given us power and authority. Every demon, every powers that is abusing you, powers of darkness that has come to abuse you, disgrace you, to shame you, to put shame on you, let them be wiped in the mighty name of Jesus. Even spirit husband, a physical husband, physical wife that are abusing you now. Those demons that are using them to abuse you, fighting you, beating you, having fights all the time, those demons that have been assigned by the devil, by the kingdom of darkness to afflict you, let this demon to die. Let them be destroyed and be rendered powerless. People say the demon does not die, but remember when Jesus ran out the demon in the beast, the pigs, the demon ran to the lake, to the sea. And there they died. Those pigs died there with the demons. So therefore, the demons who were in the pigs, they ran to the sea and died there. So it seems that the demons can go and die, or they can go somewhere where they will never come back again. They will be destroyed in the name of Jesus. I know that because I see them in the spirit. When we speak the word, they are break. Some of them, they fall down. Some of them, they get injured. Therefore, I take the authority. Any living thing, any creature, any human being that is against you, and using witchcraft, using voodoos, I destroy them. When you say destroy, which means destroy this to finish them, they will not have life. When you destroy something, it cannot have life. That's why I know Jesus came to destroy the works of God, the works of the devil. Therefore, the word of God is alive. When Jesus came to destroy, it means he came to destroy. When you destroy something, you will destroy it completely. It will not have life. It will not live there again. Therefore, I have take authority. Jesus, his work was destroy the demons, casting out demons. Therefore, I cast out every demon that has been signed by the devil. You know the people who are working in the kingdom of the of darkness, they have demons. They sent. And they have powers. Some of them, they have powers. They use their eyes to look at people and say something, and something will happen to the person. Look at this scripture of the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah, put the word in your mouth. Put the word in my mouth. Put the word in the mouth of Jeremiah. So the devil also put the words in the mouth of the devil. Those people are working with the power, working with the darkness. Kingdom of darkness. So they have been given power. The power of darkness, the power of the devil does not have any power to destroy the work of God. The devil has no power. Devil has no power. Jesus has power. People of God, Jesus has power. Devil has no power. Therefore, people of God, I am standing against the powers of darkness that is working against you. I destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Devil, Satan has no power. Satan has no power. We have been given power. We have been given word. We have given word. The word of God with authority. Therefore, I take the authority by the power in the blood of Jesus to destroy every power that is rising against you. To destroy every powers of the devil that is rising against you. Powers of the devil has no power. We have power. We have authority. We use the word and it will establish. Therefore, I am condemning and cast out every works of the enemy in your life. Thank you very much. God bless you so much. Call me. I will pray with you. I will put a curse to the enemies that is are working against you. I will cast them. I will destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, because there is power. Any child of the devil praying or talking, attacking the child of God, they will be destroyed in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. God bless you so much. I have to stop here. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. Go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. You can go all to Facebook. Go to Facebook, Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry. Facebook, we are there. All right, Christine Isigi. You can see me there in the Facebook. Go and like our page. Go and see, there's a lot of videos there. Videos are there and materials are there to help you free of charge. You can get this material free. If you need me to pray for you, if really you need a word from me, call me. Our number is 905-487-7196. If you need the word, you need me to speak the word over you, our number is 905-487-7196. All the free number, we have a free number, 877-241-3420, extension 101. Or I have cell phone. People who are outside want to text me, send WhatsApp. We have a cell phone. Our cell phone is 647-608-5207. We have cell phone. So you can reach us through cell phone, through email, overcomersdhm@gmail.com. You can reach us email, overcomersdhm@gmail.com. Or you can text now. Everybody, at least almost everybody, has cell phone. If you cannot reach us through the landline, you can reach us through cell phone. Our cell phone number once again is 647-608-5207. Thank you very much. God bless you. We have power. I have power that God has given to me. That's why when a witch who called me yesterday was trying to test me, I think the witch was destroyed, because that's what the Bible says. This witch, the witch woman, when she started talking to me, I saw before she called me, I knew she's a witch. And she called me, I said, yes, I am ready for you. I speak the word, the woman fall down. I don't know what happened to her, but the truth of the matter, the phone was on. I tried to call and then I disconnect the phone, which means she fall down. She didn't put off her phone. And she went wherever she went. I don't know. She never called me back. And I didn't bother to call her, because I knew she was a witch. Therefore, every witch in your community, every witch in your workplace, any witch that is working against you, fall down and die. Let them fall down and die. Let them fall down and die. Let them fall down and die. Fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Let them fall down and die in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. That's why you can sing to the witch. You command every witch in my place of work, in my community, in my environment, in my apartment, let them fall down and die. Let them fall down and die. Let them fall down and die. Let them fall and fall. Let them fall down and die. Let them fall down and die. Let them fall down and die. Holy Ghost fire, paralyze them. Holy Ghost fire, paralyze them. Let them fall down and die. They will fall down and die. If you don't know how to pray, remember the Bible says you will destroy them. Therefore, destroy them. You have the word. The word of God, you have as authority. So speak the word. It will be established. Jesus, you know, this man said, speak the word. The word is so powerful. Look at Luke 10 verse 19. The authority that you have. You command them, fall down and die. Fall down and die. Witchcraft in my environment. Witchcraft in my apartment. Witchcraft in my community. Witchcraft in my working place. Witchcraft in my case. You know, when you have a case, a court, the witch, they do a lot of awful. Even those judges, even the crown, even the lawyers, they are a witch. So therefore, you say, if you lawyer, you are a witch, fall down and die. You command them not to wake up. When you have a case, like tomorrow you are going to court, just paralyze them. Paralyze them. You are opponent. Paralyze them. You have authority. Say, fall down and die. Don't wake up. in the mighty name of Jesus. Fall down and die, because God has given us authority and power to destroy. Look at, refer to Jeremiah 1 verse, start from even verse from 8 to 10, and see what the word of God has given to you. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful Sunday, and see you tonight or wherever time you see me. I don't have specific time now, but I want to wish you happy, happy Sunday, and God bless you. Have a wonderful time. I will be having my birthday on 20th of May, and we will have our anniversary at the same time. So each anniversary will be 21st, or we will let you know. But my party day is coming on 20th of May. Therefore, people of God, I need you to support me, because I need to have a computer and iPad, not the iPad, and a camera, video camera, so that it can bring good pictures. For you people, this is one way of preaching. So all my gifts will go to the work of God. I need a good camera. I need a good computer whereby the virus cannot disturb us and bring trouble. Like now, all the computers have been attacked by the virus. But by the grace of God, last night, no computer was working. After I lay my hands and I prayed over the computer, when I tried this morning,